Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you and welcome to our final night of the Toorak-Prahran presentation week for season 2019-2020. Last night, we had a great presentation by Mo. Just fell short of the line in the grand final, but it was an excellent season. Well done to Mo and the players, and also to Brando and all the players who participated for the ones this season. With a bit of help, I'm pretty sure we'll go one step further next year. Looking forward to it, and I think it'll be great. But tonight, this is the big one. It's Friday night. I know the footy was on last night. There's footy on tonight. But stay tuned. Coming right up right now is the big man himself, James Kemp, and the second 11 Premiership winning sides presentation. Take it away, Kempy.
James! James! James, wake up! Wake up! Wake up! It's presentation night! You've been asleep for 4 months! Wake up!
Thanks for Alicia for waking me up. Been hungover for nearly 4 months. What a time, what a time. Hi guys, my name's Kempy. I am the captain of the seconds. I just want to wish you all, everyone, a safe and happy time in the TPCC community. I hope you're all doing well. It's very, very important, making sure you're nice and healthy, and hopefully healthier than I was after the last time I was at the club. Just a couple of things. Obviously, I'll go into it a bit more, but what a year, eh? The twos. Where do I start? If I told you that a team that won 5 wins, 6 losses, and 2 ties would win a premiership, you probably go, what the shboop? But things happen in cricket, and good teams win flags. Anyway, so at the start of the year, we ended up having... the idea of it would be to obviously blood some kids. We want to get some kids going through. And we did that. What a great year. Broadly, Ollie Bell, Travis Harrison, Brady, awesome to see him playing in the twos. Luca, great stuff. Matt Mialio, Andy Batten getting a run up there. Like I said, Brady, Siru was awesome as well. Will Roberts, all those guys playing twos cricket, great exposure. And I want to see them there next year because it's imperative and important. But what I saw this year, if you can combine a bit of youth with some experienced players that have come down, and players like Jerome, Chris Learmonth, Gunners, Rhino, VP, and Tommy Ryan as well coming back after his back injury, you can create a pretty good side. This is how crazy the year was. So we, in a short thing, we weren't that good. We finished, obviously, with 40 points, 26 points behind the top place, South Camberwell. We actually only won 3 out of 9 games. Okay. Coming to the second last game, we needed to, and I always remember this, rainy day, had all the ones players, supporters, or ones players coming back because they finished early, going for an outright against Mount Waverley, who stumped us at the start of the year. And I remember about to pull the pin in the rain, and Mo said, just keep going, Kempy. So I did. I listened to him. Thank God I bloody did, Mo. So we ended up getting the 10 points outright, and then we had the most craziest game. And we did have a bit of a help from a guy called Hugo Trotter. So they needed 40 runs, and we needed 77 wickets. It's pretty handy when you got Trotter coming along. So he came in also, Vipper. Got us over the line by 10 runs to make us in the finals, but we were still that night, we're not guaranteed it. We still had to wait for some polls to get through. It was hectic. live updates because they were going to go for outright. Anyway, we scraped in. And then we started to really play some good cricket. We ended up playing South Camberwell on the final, semi. And what an amazing game that was. A full 11 players contributed. We knocked off the best team. Screffa, Shunks, Travi, awesome stuff. Really good cricket. And the bond was there, and it was growing. And what an amazing thing to be a part of. We ended up then just going to a grand final, and when you're hot, you're hot. Amazing stuff. And we did have a bit of help from someone, and we'll talk about him later, and you're probably going to hear, or you've probably already heard, and you're going to hear more about him. But he's a pretty handy cricketer, and I'm still better at him in poker. Lastly, Neil Gumley, mate, this was your team for a lot of the time. You know, you played in, could have played in a lot lower grades, and obviously the family stuff, you stuck what was best for the club. You could quite easily, and you well-deserved, should have been probably playing. Bit unfortunate, obviously, with a couple of things. But, mate, thanks heaps. Awesome year. You know, I know that you would have loved to win a flag, but, you know, it's all the respect, mate. The captains, what a awesome stuff. Mo, you're a bloody good leader. We'll be there next year for you, mate. I'll be drinking a couple of beers, watching you hopefully, you know, get a bit of redemption. Also, Doug, awesome job again. Simo, amazing, mate, what you've done with the younger kids down there and the juniors and stuff. And Limov, mate, it's great to see that you kept that lock team going. So well done to the Skips. I've been there every Thursday, and it's a bloody hard job. And whoever's watching it, you know, there's a lot more that goes behind it. Lastly, just also, before I go to the awards, just want to say a couple of things. I want to say thanks so much to the committee. Been awesome this year. Tommy Ryan, Gummers, Ange, Iz, list goes on. Forber, amazing stuff, mate. Always with the updates and so forth. Two other people, obviously, I want to thank is Coach Alistair. I've had some interesting times with Alistair on the side of the boundary watching our team collapse. But thanks heaps for that through all the times and stuff. You're a great coach. Awesome. Thanks for your help. Lastly, but also before I go to the awards, Robbie as well. Love you, mate. I don't know. It's bring affection. You make me keep going. So thanks a lot. I'll go to the awards now. I'll come back for my last words. So here we go. The big awards. First of all, we'll start off with the Fielding Award. The Fielding Award this year was going to go to me until I dropped that catch, because I took six catches in a row. Anyway, we won't talk about that. But this bloke has been pretty good behind the stumps this year. Took an amazing catch in the granny. Awesome to see him playing twos cricket. Really enjoyed his year, and really good. Really happy to see his development through the club. And that's Chris Broadley. So well done, Broaders. As you can see yourself up there, having a bit of a licky lick. And you're a weird unit, aren't you, mate? I don't know where you get that from, but anyway. Next to me, we're going to go to the bowling average. Awesome year from this bloke. Awesome in the finals. Missed a clutch. Awesome big semi-final. He took a big fifer. He loved playing cricket. Gave a really good level head to the side this year. A lot of experience, and that's Scott Screffield. Screffield ended up having 19 wickets at 12.26. That's a pretty damn good year, Screff. Well done, mate. Look forward to having a beer with you when you celebrate with that, because that's pretty, pretty handy. Next, bowling aggregate, Shunks. What a year. He actually topped the comp with 27 wickets. Amazing year this year, Shunks. Shunks is... when I needed a wicket or whatever, he had an amazing semi-final. I kept on asking him to bring something in every single game. I'd go ask him, and he just gave more and more and more and more. And I was pretty lucky in the grand final to have a Shunks, Vipper and Screffa bowling lineup going into a finals. They're pretty potent, those three. Jeremy Skeeb on the batting. And I'm just joking. Now, you can see, look at this, one of probably the best knocks I have seen. And as much as should have won the award. No, after this knock, there's no doubt that, mate, you're a seriously good cricketer. I saw the skill, the poise, mate. You're absolutely one of the best knocks I've seen at Toorak-Prahran. 97 not out in the grand final. You kept on telling me all year that you were going to give me a big knock, and I was a bit worried about you, mate, at one stage. Before this, you were like, the average, the high score was 30, but, mate, also, Skeebs, you ended up, obviously, so 238 runs, 34, well done. But, yeah, obviously a very gun bat, but you also great, gave a great lot to the younger kids as well, mate. So, good stuff. This now brings me to the last bit, okay? The Champion Player Award. So I've got some trophies here, as you can see. All ready to go. And as you can see on the screen right there, the first person I'm going to mention is, we had a three-way tie. So the first person is Shunker. Congratulations, Shunks. Awesome year. You can't complain, really. With 27 wickets, you deserve to have it. We mean, Robbie, you're a 3-2-1, and it came out tied. Well done, mate. Awesome year. Love playing cricket with you. Good cricketer. Go around again next year because, mate, you're huge to the TPCC community. So the next person that's also in the three-way is Scref. Like I said before, awesome year, mate. Well done. And I think you played less games as well. So great year from you, Scref. Awesome in the finals, like I said. And lastly, it's probably left this person to the last, but this is a great result. This bloke was playing threes for a lot of the time in the last couple of years, and it absolutely awesome to see him, you know, to win this award. And that's Travi Harrison. So Travi, awesome year, mate. Big year from you next year. Enjoyed every moment, you know, giving a lift every whole year to the club, really, and all that stuff. But anyway, awesome, guys. Thank you very much. Have a good night.
Kempy, well done, mate. What a sensational year you guys have had. It's been absolutely brilliant to watch internally while I was playing and from afar. It was just such a good season, and to get where you were, especially when you needed an outright with a couple of games to go, make it into finals, the semi-final, what a match, taking on the top side and absolutely destroying them, and then the grand final. Skiba, Curdy, and also Screffa, all performing on the big stage. Well done, guys. And to all you out there, I'll raise a glass. It is Friday night. We're getting to that time of the week. It's been a very long week, introductions and all the presentations. So I raise a glass to Kempy and the second 11 Toorak-Prahran Cricket side on a premiership winning year. Well done, boys. Very nice. Well, now, without further ado, some people wait all year for this. Is what they... Hey, let's just settle down here. Now, without further ado, I introduce the great man himself, Robert Ary. He's here tonight to introduce the Dream Team, but also the important Robert Ary Medalist. I know a lot of you, especially Trotter, wait all season for this. This is what you hang your hat on all year. You know, Robbie, again, thank you for the season. Without you, the club doesn't run. You are a man mountain. You do everything for us, and we can't thank you enough for it. So, without further ado, I'd like to introduce Robert Ary, with the Dream Team and the Robert Ary Medalist.
Hi, everyone. I hope you're all coping well during this isolation period, and hopefully we can return to normal life by this coming cricket season. Firstly, I would like to give out the Toorak-Prahran Poker Trophy to the person who has won it the past 3 out of 4 seasons. And that goes to Jeremy Skiba. Well done, Jeremy. The second award, it's the Most Sixes Award. This is a new trophy started last season to see who is the biggest hitter at our club. This season's winner with 20 sixes is Jeremy Skiba. Coming second is Chris Learmonth with 17. The third trophy is the Duck Award. The winner for this season are new members to the club with 4 apiece ducks. Winners are Jimmy Shepherd and Curtis Airy. The next award is the Graeme Fisher Development Award, which has been around for over 10 seasons. Past winners include Hugo Trotter and Oscar Jenkins. This prestigious award goes to Geordie Moran. Well done, Geordie. To finish off the Ram medal, if you didn't know, he's named after me, for the best player within the Toorak-Prahran senior ranks. This is the dream team for this season, and the last person mentioned is the captain of the dream team and the Robert Ary Medalist. Here we go. 12 men, there's two of them, they're tied, Travis Harrison and Brandon Speedy. Batting number 11, Jerome Whelan. 10, Andrew Batten. Number 9, Scott Screffield. 8, Owen Rogers. 7, Tim Gobbo. 6, Vipul Sharma. 5, Shane Speedy. 4, Simon Izard. 3, Stephen Tanner. 2nd and vice captain of the dream team, Matthew Gobbo. And the captain and the Ram medalist goes to Jeremy Skiba. Well done, Jeremy. Well deserved. In signing off, please take care of yourselves and we'll all see each other by late October for the first match. Go Trackers! Welcome, everybody. We're about to give out the Robert Ary Medal for the 2019-2020 season. And I have the great pleasure in announcing that Jeremy Skiba has won the Ram Medal for this season. Congratulations,
Jeremy. Thank you, Robbie. Thank you.
There you go, buddy.
Thank you, Robbie. Appreciate it. Thank you once again. Let's have a beer.
Cheers, buddy.
Thank you, guys. It's always an honour getting a trophy or medal with the great man's name on it, so I really do appreciate it. It's my second Robert Ary medal. Very proud to have won it again. A couple of thanks, and that's to the skippers I play with, and in Simon Izzard, who did a great job. Loved playing with you and Gaby and Tanner and that crew. Got very close to the final, so had a great season. Thoroughly loved playing with you and seeing the work you do with getting juniors involved in the club. It's really good, mate, and I look forward to seeing all those juniors come through in the next generation. Also, James Kemp, played a few games in the twos with you. Thoroughly enjoyed that, mate. The passion you have for the club is immense. It's admirable. I love it. You make cricket a lot of fun playing with you. The semi-final and grand final we play with was fantastic. And sorry, my dog's just barking. And no, I really enjoy playing in that Premiership, mate. I'm glad that I could actually make some runs in the end. And we had a great win. Finally, to Neil Gumley, President. Great job again, Gums. You lead the club really well. To the great man, I love him to death. And, you know, he's done a great job. Dougie, for cooking week in, week out. We really do appreciate it. To all the other captains, well done on good seasons and being there in selection and all the hard yards. In particular, Momo, it's going to be good to have you back next season. You lead the club really well for our ones team. I look forward to you having a big year next year. Finally, I'm playing again next year. I've got a big accomplishment. I'm looking forward to knocking off about, 280 runs before Christmas, hopefully.
So 10 Gs.
Yes, to get into the 10,000. So I'm looking forward to coming back, playing a lot of one days, playing with a lot of you. I hope you're all safe. I'll see you in season 2021. Cheers, guys.
Congratulations to the Robert Ary medalist, Jeremy Skiba, and also to the team, the Dream Team for season 2019-2020. Some sensational performances, some great players, all richly deserved to be in that side. I was a bit short again, I think I was a bit unlucky. I ended up only making 50 runs and probably dropping 5 or 6 catches, but hey, another unlucky season. To Jeremy Skiba, congratulations on another Ram Award. What's this, your 3rd or 4th? You walk the walk and you talk the talk, mate. You come down from the lock three side up to the lock three side to play in a premiership side in the twos. You helped out where it's needed, but you also backed up scoring runs. Look, admittedly, it's probably easy scoring lots of runs against clackers, but that is absolutely sensational, mate. Congratulations and richly deserved. On to our last award for tonight, and this is the most important award of the night, and I can't thank this person enough for the effort he's put in all season. To me, this is the award that I value the most. It's the Clubman Award. It's the person who puts in the biggest effort throughout the season. Majority of the time, it's unseen and it's unheralded. We're a huge club. We're a massive club. You know, Robbie does the bulk of the work. He does a sensational job. Committee members and so on put in their time and effort. Everyone does put in a lot of time and effort. But the last couple of years, we really focused on a connection between the seniors and juniors. And I think going forward, that's going to be one of our most important roles. How do we integrate our juniors into our seniors? And again, having the club feeling a whole again. And we asked someone to step up, fill that void. And that void comes in many forms. Captaining sides, bringing up juniors through the ranks into the seniors. But also, just as importantly, we need seniors out there showing their faces, coaching our juniors. And one person did that this year, and we can't thank him enough for what he's done for our juniors, but also bringing them into our seniors, and that's Simon Izzard. Simon this year is our Clubman Award winner for not only his work as captain of the fifths, as captain of the lock side, but also he went down and coached the under 15s to a premiership, no less, and the effort he puts in every night, bringing the juniors in, and then on a Thursday night when we have selection night, he's throwing up junior names, he's bringing at least half the side, our juniors, he's either coach, he's bringing mates. He's starting to be that person we need to link our juniors and seniors, and I couldn't have think of a more worthy recipient of this award than Simon. Simon, you have been an absolute sensation, and I as a committee, because we vote on this as a community, we can't thank you enough for the effort and the time you put in, and we sincerely hope that you'll be able to do it again next season, because it's such important work you do, and you richly deserve to be awarded the Clubman for Toorak-Prahran season 2019-2020. So to that, I don't have much scotch left, it's been a big week, but Simon, thank you very much. Congratulations. Well, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. We're finished. Thank you to all the participants who've put in their presentations, who sent them in, all the captains. Thank you to all the award winners. A big thank you to Ashley Forbes. He may be leaving us for St Kilda this year, although I do expect to see him around round four or round five. But he's leaving us. He said he wanted to go babysit some under 14 and 15 year olds in the 4th 11. No, Ashley, you've been a superstar, mate. Thank you so much for all the hard work you put in. I believe you're still going to be our media manager, and you said you're going to pop down to a few training sessions wearing your security gear, so good on you with that. But I look forward to seeing you around the traps. I'm sure we'll see you most nights, because I believe St Kilda doesn't party on too hard like we do, so apparently we're going to see you most nights. So, but mate, thank you for all the work putting this all together. You've done a sensational job putting this presentation way together. Thanks so much for all the work you do, and the work you're going to do over the coming years with the Toorak-Prahran YouTube site. To the committee members this year, again, thank you. We can't do our job without you. The decisions you make my life a lot easier. To Marshy and to Tommy Ryan, my vice presidents, thank you so much for all the hard work you put in and doing all the work that you do. Ange Izzard, for all the work you do on our committee, and the work that you have been doing working with our, trying to get new club rooms and our female side, putting that together. It's been difficult through COVID-19. We've had to put a few things on the back burner, but you've been a sensational support to us, and look forward to next seasons and working together. A big thank and a big shout out to Dougie, again, the work that you do behind the scenes. You're there every week, you're there every night practically, cooking the barbecue. You're there every Friday, Saturday, Sunday mornings, and then on the weekdays, on Wednesdays, Tuesdays and Thursdays, cooking the barbecue. Mate, congratulations on all the work that you've done and on your new house. You richly deserve it, and hopefully this means that you'll still be able to get to the club rooms in time to cook the sausages, because we can't do the half the things we do without you, so thank you. To my old man, Al, mate, You said you're going to go around again next season, so I'm really rapt to hear that you're coming back again. You said you've got some unfinished business, so we really look forward to that. But thank you for all the work. We did a survey throughout the year, at the end of the season, sorry, and the one consistent message that came through was the coaching. The effort you put in and the work that you do has been sensational. Thank you so much for all the work that you have done. Everyone loves you. And we look forward to having you back again next season. And lastly, but definitely not least, Robert Ary, where would we be without you? You are the heart, soul of the club. You do everything. You do all the hard work. You do all the dirty work. You're there every night. And without you, the club wouldn't run. So, Robbie, thank you so much for a sensational season again. And last but not least, to all the players, this is the reason why we play. You are, for me, the reason why I play. We can't do the work that we do every night without our families, our wives and our partners who put in the behind the scenes efforts. So thank you to my wife, Cass, and the kids for letting me out every Saturday. So it's a big help. Lockie, thank you for working behind the camera and doing some of the videos for me. Cheers, mate. But as I said, we do what we do at the cricket club because we love playing cricket. I love playing cricket more than the next person, but what I love more is the people we play with. And that's why I play. Geez, I love winning premierships, and I've won plenty of premierships, and I've had some great times playing cricket, but the reason why I'm there every week is for 6 p.m. At 6 p.m. every Saturday night, after we've got a game, we get around with our mates, we sit down, we tell stories, and we get to spend time together. And that's the most important thing. And the one thing I've learned during this whole COVID-19 thing is we are a club full of great mates. And that's why we're so successful. We don't get success just because we want to win flags and so on. We get success because we play for each other and we're such great mates on and off the field. And I want to continue to see that grow and grow and grow. And that's why we are the largest club in Australia. We're the largest club in the Southern Hemisphere. But we're a club built on friendship and mates. And that's the one thing that I want to see us continue to do. So stay tuned. We look forward to getting into the next season. There'll be a lot of information coming out, but pre-season will be starting soon. Let's get together when we can, when the restrictions are lifted, and let's go have a drink and enjoy our camping like we do in the summertime. But for now, season 2019-2020 draws to an end, and we look forward to next season. So to everyone back home, thank you for tuning in, and have a wonderful, wonderful off-season, and we look forward to getting you back into pre-season, hopefully in around August sometime. So cheers, everyone. Good night. I'm on fire.